Praying Grace. Today I will show you my complete truck, yeah, after comms. So yesterday I came from local event, yeah, and this is how my truck looks like. So I competed in class 0, yeah, and this is my class 0 truck for local comms, yeah. So actually rules are almost the same as everywhere for class 0, like tires are smaller than 100 millimeters, full width bumpers, front and rear. So hard body, yeah, a small modifications to the high load for fenders, yeah, to clear the wheels on full articulation, for instance, or on full wheel lock, yeah. And actually that's it. So truck should have interior with the driver, yeah, side mirrors, wiper blades, some lights not functioning, but still all the lights should be on truck. Also truck should have metal sliders, yeah, actually not metal, hard ones, yeah, to hold the weight of the truck. So everybody use metal ones. Also truck should have fender flares, yeah, I believe that's what they call. So as you can see, yeah, you cannot see what's under the body, yeah, so no wires outside the body, yeah, no wires should be visible, so truck should look pretty clean, let's call it like this, yeah. Also it should not be painted, like badly painted, yeah, so should look good. As for spare tire, it should be not larger than the wheels the truck use. And I believe that's it for major requirements. As for my truck, yeah, as you can see, it's hard body, bumper in the front, yeah, fire lid for the winch, but it came out that my winch isn't functioning. Yeah, something wrong with the motor of the winch. As for the rear, yeah, rear bumper, also metal, spare tire. I just used a magnet to hold it. Actually, it worked good. So just simple mount, yeah. Because I had not enough time to fabricate something good, yeah. Also, I wanted to have like a roll bar, but had no time to fabricate it, so truck ended up like this. Some tracks, yeah, I just stay in a bed, and as my bed is pretty deep, yeah, so I had no troubles with them inside it. This was the interior. My driver without complete legs, but it's okay, yeah, so it's allowed. Seatbelt. Well, driver, I don't know, you can see. Okay, I'll try to show you, yeah. Now it's visible. So it's quite tall, yeah, so almost wraps the roof. I believe that's all I wanted to show you outside, yeah. Now I will remove the body and show you what's under the body. Okay. Under the body, yeah, what we have here. Sorry guys, just a second. Okay, under the body. It's MSTC fix What I did. I just enlightened the frame, yeah. Painted pieces of the frame, yeah. These two, that one, just from the bottom, yeah. Then I ran out of paint. So my battery was located here, as I showed you some previous episodes. Okay, my receiver, yeah. EAC, it's AM32. Acted pretty good, yeah, but I believe I need to remove all the coating from the EAC, yeah, and how do we call it? I believe I should resolder the three wires here to the EAC, because it's like there is not enough contact, maybe. I don't know. I believe I should try it. Okay, also I have like EAC for my winch. Also that EAC powers up the receiver, yeah. The winch itself. So it made out of servo, yeah. Well, I had external BEC to power the receiver and servo, yeah. 6 volts one. But when I connected all together, yeah, before the comms, when I was trying to power up the truck, yeah. I made a mistake with plus and minus wires, yeah. I mean positive wire and negative wire of the BEC. I was wrong when I was connecting, yeah, and I believe my BEC is not functioning now. Because I had some smoke, yeah, in somewhere here, yeah, from negative and positive wires, yeah, so I had some smoke, insulation became dark, yeah, that is why I had them off, and actually I didn't try to power up BEC once again, yeah, I just removed it and used some BEC built in my UNC EC, yeah, to power up the truck. And my winch haven't started, yeah. So something wrong either with the motor itself inside, yeah, or maybe with the contacts here, because I resoldered them, but haven't tested them after I assembled the winch. Anyway, I did my course without the winch, and I did pretty good. Yesterday, when we had like 3 or 4 trucks left, I was in top 10 out of 40, I believe, trucks. Anyway, I'm waiting for final results, yeah, and if there are some corrections in numbers, yeah, I drop them like comment or maybe like subtitle, something like this. So what I'm planning to do with the truck, yeah, I need to sort out the winch, yeah, itself. Also I need to do something with the external BEC, so I have spare one or two, maybe. I need to resolder them, reconnect them, yeah. Also I'm planning to give some attention to wires of the truck itself, yeah. Perhaps I will change layout of wiring, so maybe I will move receiver on the winch here, yeah. And place maybe some power wire somewhere here, maybe, yeah. Maybe I will relocate EAC, because now it's quite tough under the body, yeah. I have enough space, yeah, but I don't like how it all looks, so need to do something with it. initially I thought about placing winch EC somewhere here, yeah, but when I put the body on, there is not enough space here, yeah, so that is why I decided not to do it. Also, I need to finish some headlights, yeah, for the truck, rear lights, because I inserted diodes in the front here, yeah. I believe you can see, but they are not connected, yeah, I need to do something with it, connect them. Also, I not lost one mirror, yeah, but it came off. So I need to put it back in place. My truck now it's quite dusty, yeah, but there is almost no scratches and dents, yeah, so just dusty, a little bit dirty truck. As for the tires, yeah, I like them. Also, I will now maybe add some thoughts to that to stage foams, yeah, dual stage foams, self-made dual stage foams, and I liked how they perform. And guys, I believe that's it for the series. Yeah. Also, I will need to sort out something with front springs. I want them to be a little bit softer. Yeah, but it's the softest spring I found locally. It's for Excel SCX10-2, aftermarket one, progressive. Yeah. Softest available, but it's pretty hard for my truck. I want it to be something like this, maybe, because the overall spring rate is okay, yeah, but I don't like right height of the truck. In the rear I have also springs from 4 ECX 10-2. This one's little bit harder than front ones, but I like how they performed. Yeah, I like the height of the truck, so I will leave them as it is. Well, now I will clean the truck, yeah, and start improvements that I already mentioned. Yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Bye.